think everybody knows this jive. So guys, hello everybody, good afternoon. Today we would like to start with the powerful and happy and amazing light jive from Brian and Carmen. Yeah, I think everybody knows this jive and it gives a lot of motivation for sure. A lot of, nice energy. Oh, light is pushing badly. Okay, so guys, today we decide for jive and probably we're gonna also show something because also a lot of questions came in the private messages about the center. Center is the center power.
And, yeah, center and music today was a lot of, yeah, about music center and music.
So we decided for the jive and yeah, there was also other questions about mental things before the competition. And yeah, probably we can speak shortly about that. That some people think that like couples, finalist couples don't have any more stress before they are going to compete, but it's totally not true. All of us are humans and all of us have fears and all of us has a bit shaking on the legs before to go on the floor, especially if the competition was not long time, especially now probably next competition will be stressy for all of us because we don't have any more that experience every weekend or sometimes two competition per weekend. And yeah, it will be a bit stressy because it's something which is not our body forgot. Yeah. So, but it's okay and it's normal. Everybody has that and it's, we just need to accept it. Yeah, doesn't matter what, we all have stress. Just need to realize why comes the stress. Like we can put the stress a little bit less. For example, for me, stressy if I come to competition 10 minutes before or even 1 hour before, I need a little bit time. I don't like to speak to the people around. I don't like to make so much fun as normally because I'm very funny and open person. But during the competition, I normally like to be in my box. So this is important. For Marius, it's other way around. He would like to come as late as possible.
As late as possible and he's, have as the most jokes as possible. It has to be the most.
He like to go
day.
Around and make fun.
Yes, and if you can, you don't need to
just
keep
switch off the.
Yeah, basically you don't need to keep, let's say, stuck, you know, near each other. If one needs to do something, it can do something. The other one can have his freedom about it. And just try to make this what you feel the most comfortable with on the competition day. And another thing what is happening, if you want to go outside of the box, let's say, and be sure that somebody which is having the knowledges of doing that to you, of putting something out what you normally feel stressed but positively stressed about it, make sure that person is having the tools to do it. For example, a psychologue, a coach, one of the teachers which know how to do these things. And for example, you have a bad mood and you danced actually bad, but you need actually a push. Make sure to allow the right people to do that for you. And all of you have somebody which will gonna take that out from your soul, from your mind, from your body. And this would be a great advice. This would be for sure a great advice.
Yeah, also, for example, parents are very different. Like probably some dancers don't really like that parents stay near. And some likes, like for example, the mother of Marius is very easy going, so she doesn't really stress you. But if you need some help, she always open to do that. Yeah, so it from person to person, and you have to know what is good for you, what is not good for you, and also speak between you. So for example, as I said, if I like to come a little bit early to competition, I ask Marius, let's come a little bit early, like this I'm not stressed. So, and if he wants, for example, if the competition in the hotel, that is the best, like this I can go by myself in the hall already, being there in the changing room, and Marius can come a bit later.
Sometimes happens also that Khrystyna takes a taxi and arrives in the competition faster than me. Because I tell you something now which is very strange. The most sure and unstressed I feel if I take the dancing clothes, if I change into the dancing clothes, maybe 15 to 10 minutes before the round is starting. So this is very, very
strange. We have always joke, Charles know that, we can, I think, speak
yes.
openly.
When Charles put the number
and go to the dance floor,
I know that I can start the warm up.
Yes. But now he's a little bit more chill,
yes,
have to say.
Yes, yes, yes. One time I think Charles was late. And he was late and he started to dress up in the same time when I started to dress up. And then I understood, oh, maybe I should hurry up a little bit because he was already in panic. Yeah. But I mean, nothing is good and nothing it's bad. It's the way how you feel to do it. Of course, at the end of the day is not to be late. And unfortunately, if I'm a little bit late, I'm still not stressed. So I thank the organizers for that. Sometimes they call my number, but I'm really not stressed about it. I would feel much more stressed if I would have to be ready, I don't know, 1 hour before and stay near the floor and all this stuff. Okay, another advice is make sure that the people around you do it for you and it's about you in the competition, yeah? It's not about them, because this is the most easy to get the help from somebody if that, when it's everything about the one which is competing, yeah? This is important. So these are the people which can help the best, yeah? Then what other things are functioning, yes, in this kind of situations is that you have many things distracting you from your own performance on that day. Yes, you can watch the other dancers, your competitors, and you think how good they are or you think how bad they are. Both are, let's say, a situation where you shouldn't use it. This means don't watch the competitors, because either if you think they are good or if you think they are bad, it's an external stress, an external stuff. It cannot really change your performance with nothing. The lightning, the public, you know, when you dance in front of the people which are probably the fans of the competitor, or when you, I don't know, when you dance with an empty hall, all these kind of things can have a negative influence on your performance. So what you have to do, you have to stick to this, what your plan is. This means dance the choreography in your head, think about what you or rehearse what you would like to show on the floor, hear good music, yes, every time, watch videos maybe, or have thoughts about your stars, yes.
Good, like, also to hear the music which you were hearing when you were small.
Exactly.
This makes you no fear, because the children, they don't have still a lot of experience, so they don't afraid about something. They are not afraid about something, yes. So this is the good thing to come back to your childhood, yes.
Exactly.
To listen some music which you are listening when you were a child. This also I do sometimes between the rounds, or I sing this song.
Exactly. And try every time when such an exterior stress is coming. I don't know, other example can be a stressed out organizer, yeah? They trying to do their best, and we are always thankful for this, what the organizers are doing for us, but sometimes they can have stress with other things, and I don't know, they can rush you, come on guys, you need to be on time and all this stuff. In that moment, try to switch to this, what you have to do. And what you have to do is basically dance and everything what is connected with your performance. I don't know, do your makeup, do your hair, try to have your clothes clean from round to round. Stick to this, what you have to do. And especially when you get stressed, you stay near the floor because you're waiting your round. You're waiting to dance your hit, and exactly in front of you is dancing the competitor. What are you doing? In that moment, you don't watch, or you basically know that through watching, yeah?
Think
and you go your choreography into the head. You go your stuff into the head, yeah? What you want to show, everything. All these kind of advices, I think, would be great.
Yeah, also, for example, what I learned from one psycholog as well, he said that if you don't want to speak to the people, you are not ready for that during the competition, just put the headphones. Even if you are not listening to the music, you put the headphones and automatically people are not speaking to you because they think you are not hearing them. So this is also good thing about that. Of course, if people make you stressed, if you speak with them.
Yes. Yeah? Try to find your place where you are in your mood. For example, in my case, I need to find a place where I have some friends around, where I throw some jokes. Yeah, Khrystyna needs to find a place where she's quite alone. If there is no stress between you, with that you can also get a different place. Khrystyna wants to know where I am. She doesn't want to know, for example, what I'm doing, but she wants to know where I am. So every time I need to tell her, look, Sunshine, I go to buy some food. Do you want some? Look, I will gonna go now to the teacher, or this kind of stuff.
Yes? I will save the live streaming, don't worry.
Exactly. Yeah, all this kind of stuff I think will be good advices for you and for your performance during the competition. Another thing, learn to accept. Learn to accept is very, very important. Because if you are afraid, don't say you are not afraid. I mean, guys, do you know this feeling of entering, for example, in the German Open for the first solo dance? Yeah, you enter in the first solo dance and you go like, enter in the floor and you get, my God, what is this? Yes. And then you think like that. You have actually a carrot inside the back. Yeah, you are quite afraid about the situation, but then you say yourself, it's okay, let's see what I can do with that. Accept it and start to play with the tools you have. Just accept it, just say it's okay, so, and go for it. Don't try to say no, don't try to fight against it. The moment when you try to fight against it, it will gonna be probably more heavy. Accept it and go and start to play with your tools. Come on, I'm here. I need to see how I can deal with all this situation, with all these people watching, with all these people, probably waiting for a great performance. The people are there to, they want to be touched, actually. They are there to watch you at the end. The message is a positive message, yes? And they are first of all not there to try to judge you, okay? The judges should judge, this is another thing, yeah? We have an advice also about how to think about the judges, but this we will probably give in private, yeah? Try just to accept the situation and to do the best out of it and come back to your skills. Come back to your skills all the time.
Yeah, and also, guys, try to speak to your teacher. Probably they have a lot of students and all of the students are different. Somebody likes when they shout on them and say, look, stretch your legs. Some of them like that you just give positive feedback. So try to say to your teacher what is good for you, what you would like that he tell you during the competition. Of course, afterwards in the practice time, he can tell you the truth, yes? But in the competition time, probably if you feel being hurt from your teacher giving you some feedback, which you don't really like to hear during the competition, just speak to him like this. The teacher know what is good for you. Yeah, but afterwards, of course, by the practice time, he need to tell you the truth to make you better.
Exactly. There we get some questions.
Should Lisa, we... don't be bad. Eh? There is certain jokes you are pushing. The Lisa, which is doing my head.
So, we get this question where he asks us, please answer.
Yeah, all the
who's
time
your favorite couple in WDC? Guys, we do not have a favorite couple.
But we like many.
We like many couples. Dancers. Yes, and it would be very, very strange from us now, again, I repeat it, if we would give some particular answers. Because, I mean, there are so many top couples which we like. And generally, all the finalists are doing a great job and we feel inspired. There are some couples in the semifinal we
Lisa.
Feel inspired. There are some couples also in the 24. I mean, we enjoy watching a lot.
There are many.
And
many.
We enjoy watching also specific dances on some couples also, yes?
Yes. That was also.
Is the dance music really important? The dance music is really important, but it's especially really important in the moment of the practice, when you practice on it, yes? Because you bring things, you save things into your body. On good music, you save, you get a much better dancer, yes? The muscles are learning through repetition. So if you repeat on good music, you will gonna dance much better in the competition. In the competition, you cannot really control which music is playing. Besides, you have experience with some typical events which use orchestra. For example, when you go to German Open, you kind of know that you will gonna have an orchestra.
Or in WDC Blackpool.
Or WDC Blackpool, or all this kind of stuff. But try to practice with good music is very important. Let's see some other question.
About the style.
I'm counting when I'm nervous and it helps. Yes,
this is Lisa.
This is nice.
She has nothing to do with dancing, but she's with us. Lisa, I'm gonna do with you online fitness. Like this, you know what to do. Because she says she miss working. She want to go to work. Yes, guys, this is the moment when we realize how much we like to be busy and how much we like our job. Because we miss it now in the moment.
Should you really put pressure on the floor when your dancing shoes are slippery? Good advice, make sure that your dancing shoes are not slippery.
Yeah, we prepare normally day before our shoes. Okay, plus minus we already know every floor.
Look at this one.
So we brush them in the night and we put ricin oil. Yeah, and it stays for over the night and normally we have no problem with the slippery.
This is the best. Last year we took a picture in the changing room and Marius went in sweatpants 10 minutes before the round started. Exactly, this is the point I was talking about before.
Stressful before the con. We answered this question, of course. We have certain stress before competition.
What is the most important thing for you when you dance? To love it. To love it, guys. You need to love it. How much do we practice per day? We said this actually before. We practice two times, short sessions are 1.5 hours when we are home. 1.5 to 2 hours, two times per day.
The favorite dress, guys, by costumer for the moment was the first dress they did for me with the roses. But I have one new dress which you didn't see because I needed to put it on my German championship, German clothes championship. But you will soon see it and it's my favorite one. Stressed on the floor.
Oh, we get said. Do you get stressed on the floor when
yes,
we get stressed of many things and we try to do many this kind of things what we wrote you before, what we said to you before.
This is nice also question. I receive it also online privately. How do you build your own style? Guys, look, when we were small, we were watching many videos of a lot of different dancers, yeah, and then you start to create in your mind what you like more, what you like less. So probably this influence your mind, and in the future you know how you want to look like. Yeah, so for sure when we were small we were copy our teacher normally, yeah, our teacher or the videos which we were watching. So with the time, when you are still small, it's good to copy, but with the time you are getting older, you are getting more mature, you start to realize what you like and you start to create your own style. Means that all of us have their own opinion and character, so it's everything influence, and then you create your own who you are. I mean, when somebody is drinking, he drink in his way because this is how he used to do. Yeah, it's yeah, exactly. So it will gonna come with the time, I guess. So your own style and your own feeling to what you want to do.
Some advices to people who training at home: follow our videos. Yeah, we try to do choreographies which are small.
Just we forgot yesterday to count our rumba choreography. We're gonna do it later in the story,
exactly.
So you can check it out.
Exactly.
Your facial expression is so good. Yes, thank you.
A good advice about your facial expression is probably to try to listen to your body. Try to listen to your body to more or less observe your body and try to get a full message from all the body. This means face connected with the body. For example, you do this kind of figure, yes, and you have, I don't know, this kind of movement, and you have something like that.
It's hello, not really possible. Hello, do you
so have... it's more like a funny thing, yeah? It got connected fully. Or you do this movement and then this face will gonna pass. Because you try to observe that you give out the same energy, that you are fully on the same energy.
Somebody do you think reach? Do you think you will ever reach the first place?
Of
we
course.
Believe in that, guys, and that's why we are continue to dance, because we have our target, and for sure we believe in that we can win.
Yes, we have the
physical
the sport
psychologist
mental trainer, yes.
We have. It's good to put Coca-Cola on dance shoes.
Generally, things which are with sugar are more sticky.
Sticky.
Yeah, but depends on the dancing floor. Sometimes the dancing floor can be very sticky and you need to
It depends,
to
yeah, what
slide
you like.
More.
We like also like. That it's sliding, but it's not too much.
Exactly. This is why we put the evening before, like Khrystyna said, the oil. The, I don't know how it's called, ricinus oil.
Ricinus oil.
Yes.
Male body. The most important, it also depends from the Latin or ballroom guys. Who I know, especially the standard guys, they shouldn't have too much big muscles on the on
arms,
the hand,
they
arms
should be
here.
Quite thin, yes.
Because the frock is not looking nice, and also, yeah, I don't know exactly the reason, but they have very strong legs, but less upper part, because it's probably not that nice looking in the frock. And in the Latin as well, if you do your muscles, it's important that you are still flexible enough. Because Marius just told me yesterday that Arnold Schwarzenegger or who was...
Yeah, I saw some... guys, actually, it's very interesting. I saw some pictures with Arnold doing exercises at home. I think he did some advertising when he was active, yeah? Guys, the stretches what he did with all these muscles, it was incredible. I don't know if... we can probably forward that to you or put it somewhere, but what stretches we saw there with such a big muscle, you know, he was Mr. Olympia, I don't know, 7 years or something like that. Wow, incredible, incredible.
When you guess, just started dancing, did you believe that you will come here where you are right now?
Not when we just started dancing, but very early in our career. Very, very early in our career.
Yes, this video we're gonna save so you can watch it later from the beginning. There are already
I danced ballroom. I danced ballroom and Khrystyna danced also when she was little. And I danced till 16 and a half, 17. What do we do to keep fit for the competition? Guys, full program. Like, I mean, we are doing that as a full job. What kind of male dance clothes is the best? Guys, it depends on the, taste. For example, me, because I'm quite big, yeah, and I try to keep it as simple as possible. Not that much stones, and I like more a male, like without stones. There are different options, but I like also, for example, stones on other males. So it's regarding my person, I would probably not wear that much, but I like it on other people. So don't get like, it's very relative. Don't get, try to see what you like on you the most.
Do you think you will dance ballroom back?
No,
I think
we
it's
will
too late.
Not dance. It's too late for that. How old are we now? 29. No problem.
Marius, best quality. I think that Marius can think in the especially critical moments cold. Yeah, he is not reacting directly, but he is always thinking before to say something and before to give the solution. So it's like not connecting to the dancing that much, but like personal, his quality is this. But in the dancing, he is very motivated and he knows what he wants and he practices a lot. And yeah, I think this is the... best qualities of him. He's like a machine in this way. But still with the jokes. The difference between WDC and WDCF. I have no idea. I think it is the same in the way, I mean, we are all dancers, we have same...
I think it's very personal.
Criteria.
We try to put things in boxes. I think it's very personal for couple to couple, depending on which environment they have near them. The environment is created from the team of the teachers, and the people surrounding you and education from the family, from the school. And this is more or less very personal. There are schools, different people in WDSF to us, inside of our own federation, inside of their own federation.
Some people try to ask provocating questions like this, like WDSF, WDC, Svetlana and Armen.
They have some qualities. They have some things which are probably not that good in our eyes. But I mean, they are there where they are because they are good dancers. So
yes,
they for sure have a lot of qualities.
To them, they're going to start amateur. Yeah, I think the moment from youth coming to amateurs is the one of the difficult moment in the dancing career of every dancer, because you are still young and you are going to amateurs where the people are quite mature already. But we all pass through that, and I think you just need to concentrate about that what you are used to do, and just practice a lot, and everything will come with the time. Because sometimes I remember I had always problem that sometimes teachers were telling me, you are too young, you dance like not like a woman yet. But you cannot dance like a woman when you are still probably 15 years old. So everything will gonna come with the time. It's important that you concentrate and stay focused on the things you are working on.
We will try to do a direct live every day. Yes, we will try to do it. Let's see. How much we do physical training in a week, probably, but depends. Physical training can be through dancing, physical training can be through exercises, through stretching and all this stuff. Probably 30% to 40% of our preparation per week.
Do you practice how your hands move? Hey, yeah, for sure we are doing that, but again,
it comes out of the body.
We said yesterday, it's come always from the body, so it's more about the coordination of our body and the hands. It's more a reaction of that what is body is doing.
Are you considered amateurs? I'm sure you are pros, so are allowed to teach students, guys. It was before, I think, a system before in England was like this build up, which had his good things also, that there were amateurs and there were pros. The amateurs were not allowed to teach and the pros were allowed to teach. I think nowadays it's a little bit different. Things developed in a different way, fortunately or unfortunately. I think in our federation, the majority, or let's say the level, is probably, let's say, stronger through a majority of couples. In amateurs, it is the way it is, and we are considering ourselves professionals, because we just said before, more or less we do a full job. So a full job means actually you have a profession, yeah? We don't have other stuff beside dancing. I know people from the past, which were great champions, were talking to us and they say they needed to work to have a normal job because they were not allowed to teach as long as they were amateurs. But it's, I think, different times. You see, we are 29 and we are still amateurs. I mean, this was not probably the case before the people went to pro as fast as possible. How do you make your jive look easy and light? Okay, before we come to that, do you still practice basic a lot? So let's come to this. How do you make your jive look easy and light? This is actually a nice one. And now I think we could start with that, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Because I think we, around the world, we have a lot of knowledges in samba, cha-cha, rumba, because these are the dances which are practiced the most. And this is great also. And we hope and we think also that jive and paso doble could be also practiced the most. I mean, every dance is 20% out of our full result. And they should be treated equally from us as dancers. And I think, though, the knowledge in the other dances, samba, cha-cha, rumba, it's somehow bigger. The time what we invest is bigger than in paso and in jive, which is a little bit of a pity. But maybe we can give you today some advices how to get that jive done, you know, because this would be
the keyword center.
And the center, yes, this is a good thing, because you wrote us a lot of stuff, and the stuff what you wrote was majority was made from like consisted from center and they said about music, center and music. Yes, exactly. So I think this is a nice topic to show you some jive skills maybe. So let's go for it.
Yes. Yeah?
Let's see.
I make you, I'm filming you.
Yes, you, Khrystyna filmed me. So, we were gonna do just some basic stuff, yes? We were gonna have some basic stuff. For example, we're gonna take chasses, we're gonna take probably some kicks, and we were gonna take some two-step combinations, like for example, back replace, yes? So, we're gonna have, for example, the chasse, just a second. Yeah. So, guys, for example, let's think a little bit about that. We were gonna speak a little bit about that downswing. Yeah. And let's see how we can get that. So we have, for example, the chasse. We have quick. Yes, quick. The steps. Yeah. And there are many variations going, and we find them okay. But we would like to give you some advice, maybe some input, and try to play a little bit with that. Let's figure out that before every single two, which is basically this one is the two, yeah, the last quick, we should have a drop, yeah? So we try to connect it with a drop, and this is the downswing, yeah? If we go quick, ah, quick, yeah? This would be a great one. For example, if you do the same in the kicks, yeah? Let's have a downswing after we kick, for example, and we have something like quick, ah, quick. Instead of, for example, dancing on the same level, yeah? Which is also a possibility and is not bad. But if we speak a little bit about the music and to see how the music is built up, would be a great advice to have that drop exactly before that one, a two. Now, if we come to this step, for example, yeah, we cannot really drop in the knee, yeah, because it's basically from the book also not really allowed. But we can still have a drop inside of the body, which will gonna allow us to connect and to go quick, ah, quick. Other leg, then quick, ah, quick, kick. And make sure you do it before you take the second quick before. So don't go quick. Make sure you were gonna do it here. Quick.
So guys, if you see, it's always on one. He's up, on two is down, and between is a drop. Up, drop down. Up, drop down.
One, two. Okay.
That's how it, we believe it looks easy.
Exactly, and probably passing very much to the music, which is singing, especially to the rhythm, which is singing, yeah? Because the music can be different, but the rhythm can be, it's probably the same, yes? Now, Khrystyna, we're gonna speak a little bit about the center stuff, yeah? On the same three possible combinations, okay? Let's see that.
So guys, here we were young and beautiful.
Young and wild.
Correct. So guys, Marius were speaking about the foot more or less and the direction of the weight. Yeah, it goes up, drop down, and finishing up, and again up, drop down, and finishing up. But what we also try to do is in this area, we try to keep the active movement. I call it also like a bouncing in the stomach area. So like this, you look easy. Yeah, I show you a bit my stomach. So this is what we normally use also like an exercise. So we always do open, close,
open, close, open, close, open, close. Ta, ta, ta. A one, a two, a one, a two. This is the exercise we are usually doing before to start. Yeah, so don't try to do that much. We always keep our center inside, never outside. But in this exercise, we try to little bit opening the chest and bringing the pelvis backwards, then we bring it in. Back in, back in. But I'm not doing that with the shoulders as well. I'm trying to keep my posture and doing it just in that area. Yeah, so if I do, for example, kicks, I don't do just from the leg as well. This is the difference between kick and flick. If I do kick, I don't really activate my stomach area, but when I'm dancing the flick, then I'm activating my stomach area, my center area. Yeah, so I do a one, a two, a one, a two. And as well, when I'm catching my standing leg, I try not just to open the stomach and staying that way, but as I'm standing on my standing leg, I try also to keep the rotation on the leg. So like this, it looks more nice. And as well, my leg, I'm not kicking it directly straight, I'm kicking a bit diagonally. So I go, ta, a one, a two, a one, a two, one, drop down, drop, ta, ta, up, up. So you see that it's looking more light.
Yes, and it has a little...
Just that.
Exactly.
Ta, 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 ta. Always that. One,
exactly.
One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one. One, a two, one, a two. And the same with the chassis, for example, if I go, ta, a, ta, a, ta, a, closing, dropping, step, closing, rotate. Ta, ta, ta. And one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Two, three, one, two, three, one. Ta-ra, ta-ta, 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 ta-ta. Rather doing just the legs and this area is standing.
Yeah. This was great. This was great. So, we should try a little bit with the music. We should try a bit with the music.
Yeah, we can do that. But probably...
Maybe you change the camera to you.
Okay. Guys, yes. Today is very nice weather and very hot. So, I hope it's very clear and you got something. If you have some questions, you can ask. Today we try as well to film jive choreography like this. You can use these principles and we will try to see. Also using just the kicks and maybe chassis, just very easy combination. And again, guys, yesterday I posted a Roomba video a bit late. Probably not everybody saw it yet. But it's on my page, you can check it, learn the choreography, practice and post on your page, tagging us. That's like this we can see, not for something else, just when you tag us, we can see it, yeah. Can you advise how learn a split fast when you are not that flexible? What does it mean, split? Can you give me advice how to learn a split fast? I'm not sure I understood what does it mean split. So here is the music. Guys, about personality to show on the dance floor, I think everybody of us has their own personality, so you don't need to practice it. I mean, just show yourself. Be yourself. Yes, I am done.
For example.
Okay. And you see that also he's using that in this center area, that bounce, let's call it bounce action.
On the chassis, let's see.
Ciao, Jacobo!
For example, now Christina will
watch. Okay. split and fresh spagat.
Explain how to practice it.
Yeah, this is a nice one. Yeah, this is a nice one. Okay, let's, for example, this one, you know these guys when people do it like that? If you were gonna drop it for every second one.
Throwing out the garbage.
A one, a two, and you were gonna get that rhythm inside of your body. Two, up. My baby don't care.
So guys, here was a little bit of dancing. For sure you were not doing it with us, but you were just laying on the couch. But I hope that today, afterwards, you were gonna practice it a little bit. Then we can have a similar jive to Brian. Yeah, at least
we try
to get close to him.
We try.
Yeah. About spagat split, guys. For sure, it takes a lot of time. Don't try to do it from today till tomorrow. It takes time. You need to work with people which know about stretching. I was doing it since small. I was always having stretching lessons, ballet lessons, and physical preparation. Yeah, so it needs time. Don't try to put the target in front of you and say, look, in 1-2 months, I want to go to the split. So every day, just try to make it more and more and more. I cannot really show you the exercise, but yeah, probably watch some YouTube or speak to the people who knows about that, and it's possible. Yeah, for sure. In the more older you are, more difficult to get spagat done. Yeah, it's probably from the when you are small, the muscles are more elastic and you can do it better. But still, it's possible. And of course. For the dancing, you don't really need it. I mean, it's if you can do split spagat, would be nice. But for example, some girls are lifting their legs and holding with the hand. I always say to the girls, look, if you cannot lift your leg without holding with the hand, better don't do it. Yeah, so it's also not just about elasticity, it's also about the power. So if you are able to bring your leg up without holding with the legs, that would be fantastic. And I always say to the girls, better lower than and without the help of the hands, rather higher and with the hand holding my leg. I think everybody can do that, yeah, but to hold it without the hand will be more difficult. So yeah, we for sure we do all the to make more flexible our body. As I said, we practice, we're doing stretching after every practice session, and sometimes we do the stretching extra.
So they're asking, why do you think the Russian couple keeps winning? I personally think, okay, I'm not going to continue to read it, guys. You should ask the judges, not us, you know. We are trying to do our best, and we hope that one day the judges will gonna. We're gonna approve that, and that we were gonna win. But this is not thing which are dependent on us. The same. This
for
are,
sure we would like
external stuff.
To this win. It's not that we are okay with that being always behind. Of course we want to win, guys, and we are doing all our best to be there. But also we love so much dancing that for sure the result is important, but we also love to dance. So I mean, exactly. If we would not love to dance, probably we would gonna stop it already long time ago.
Exactly.
We have our target, we practice hard for that, and one day probably we will receive the cup.
Yes.
Khrystyna had Russian partner.
Oh,
before.
Guys, don't fight. Come on, don't fight. Everything is okay.
Yeah, guys, please don't be negative
don't
on
be
our
negative,
page.
Exactly.
We want to keep a positive feeling, and we try to do this live streaming actually only because we feel that also in Instagram and all the social media, it's a little bit too much of negative emotions. We want to keep positive. We don't fight. We have no jealousy to nobody, really. And we wish you not to have jealousy, exactly. Not to fight.
Think positive. Try to think positive and think about what you... Generally, every time when there is something happening around, yes, and you feel that you get, sticked in the back, think of what you have to do. Try to get better and...
The most important, guys, is you yourself, and you are happy with what you have and what you are doing. I mean, you should love yourself. Nobody will gonna love you more than you love yourself. So this is the most important. Keep positive, please. And we don't really like this kind of fights. We never do that. We don't like it. And we are really positive. We have no complexes about all these kind of things. Like, really nothing. We are really open-minded, and we are finally okay, yeah, so just be positive, especially when you're watching our live stream. If somebody doesn't like us, just don't watch us, yeah? That's also fine. You watch us fine,
guys,
and don't watch
you
us.
See, for example, there is somebody writing Russians are great. There are so many great couples around the world. Russian couples, German couples, Romanian couples, English couple, and from all where, American couples. There is so much for people to give, so try to be curious, not furious.
Yes.
This would be great if you are curious and not furious to see what is happening, especially now in this moment. Let's be honest, we would probably not gonna have the time to share this kind of stuff with the people if we would not have all this kind of situation. And we hope that you are curious about it, and we try to make you curious about it, and for sure not furious. This will not gonna help us nowhere. And I think let's try to have some inspiration and to keep positive on the track till everything will gonna get to normal. And of course, if you wanna continue to follow us further on, we would be really happy about it. But please do that if you feel inspired. And if not, then not. I see that many dancers are doing this kind of stuff now, and we are thinking, we have a very good opinion
and
about it.
And a lot of teachers are using
exactly.
our small choreographies,
exactly.
Teaching their students. That's really nice. We appreciate that. And it's all about the dancing, guys, about being in that thing which we really love. Yeah, and again, this world love. We don't fight, we don't make problems. It's just about dance and love and the world make happy, yeah. We will manage this situation.
Exactly. So have a nice time. And I think with everything being said, we would love to meet you tomorrow again. We will do also tomorrow something again. Write comments and let's see what we will gonna choose. Today we choose a little bit this music stuff. We try to connect it to Jive. And a little bit this center thing, yeah. There was some people also around center, yeah. So hope you get inspired. And
make your abdominals.
And you get curious about it and try to play with it. Don't get crazy about it, but try to play with it. And maybe you are gonna find new ways in your development. And especially now when you have a lot of time, okay? Shanghai, hope to see you soon.
Yes, China, we already, guys from China, Asia, we already miss you. Not only Asia, like all the guys, because we can see you only online by calling you or something. So we really miss that chatting between you live, not on the phone. But hopefully it will gonna finish soon so we can see
Saverio
each other.
Saverio Danceport, Cristina, sei bellissima.
Grazie, Saverio.
Ma chi è questo ragazzo con gli occhiali?
Occhiali, questo professore di danza sportiva.
Okay,
so guys, we love you all. Be positive, stay motivated, never stop the dancing, practice at home, watch our videos, learn choreographies, post them. And yeah, we will gonna post now probably the video and in the stories with the counting, the rumba choreography. Like, this who didn't get that, you can check it out. And see you tomorrow. Write us the advices about topic to speak. We will read that and try to satisfy all of you. Bye bye, guys, have a nice day.